Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz.
Hello everyone, and welcome to my walkthrough of Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz. No intro this time, because, well, there's not really much of an intro. It's all pretty much incorporated within the main game itself. So, we have a bunch of different characters, they have different attributes, and like sizes, and jump heights. Nyan Nyan is the highest in jump height, Gon Gon is the largest, Baby's the smallest. You can pretty much tell which character has which attributes just by playing with them and their appearance and whatnot. I'm going to be playing through all the worlds, one video at a time, one world per video, and the reason why I'm going to be doing that is for organization, and I'm expecting the later worlds to be ridiculously hard. Gold banana! Oh, the poor monkeys! They were worshipping their bananas peaceful-like, and then this guy comes along and he's like, I am going to steal your golden fruit, and there is nothing you are going to be able to do about it. And that's pretty much the story of the game. You gotta go get your bananas back. But you know me, I don't play games for their story, I play them for their gameplay. And this game is right up my alley. The monkeys are mad, but it's gonna be fun going through the stages, so I guess they'll forgive them in the long run. So here we go, World 1. Monkey Island. Let's start! You've seen the controls, basically. You tilt the Wii remote to move and the A button to jump, and that's it. You can pause with the plus button. You can also do that to save replays after you beat a level. And that's pretty much it. The minus button will take you back through menus if you are in menus, so it's not actually the B button, which is surprising. Just something to make a little note there. Anyway, so this walkthrough is pretty much just going to be for fun. No super high, I don't want to say high quality, I mean like super pro professional walkthrough style of super speed, you know, trying to get through the stages as fast as I can. No, this is just going to be casual monkey fun here. So if you're looking for a more perfect run, so to speak, of Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz, you best look elsewhere, especially since I haven't played this game in ages. And yes, I will be going through all the worlds, including the secret worlds. No guarantees that I'll be able to do them smoothly, but I'll go through them regardless. So this is our first stage with a jump. Whoa, look at that jump. Oh man, that was a tough jump. Doctor, stop telling me how to save replay data. I know how to press the plus button. Look at me, I pressed the plus button. Well, actually, you have to hold the plus button on the controller, but wow, that is a vigorous stance. Number four, and this is like easier than the first stage, I swear. I mean, just look at this. It's just, you just jump up there, and oh look, there's the goal. You just gotta walk through that ring. Why? It's so much easier than the first stage. Maybe the idea is to go around and collect these bananas like this, or something like that, I don't know. And by the way, your jump is pretty easy to control. You can even, like if you see yourself falling off an edge, you can use that edge to actually jump yourself back onto the platform. As long as you're in the air, you can control your momentum. See that? See, he was falling off the edge, but yet when I jumped, I was able to get myself back on the platform. So I'll use that to your advantage, especially in later levels when it's going to be pretty dang scary. Bonus stage! I've never been a fan of bonus stages in games. If you've watched my walkthroughs, you know that. I always say that bonus stages take away from the actual action of the game. I mean, this is just me. I'm collecting bananas, and this isn't very invigorating, and that's pretty much how I feel about bonus stages, and yeah, maybe I'll just jump off the edge on bonus stages on future ones or something like that, I don't know. Just to skip them and get them over with. Bonus stages are completely optional, although I do think you lose a life if you jump off the stage in a bonus stage, so maybe that's not a good idea. This is the first one with some real deal slopes here. Oh man, this is going to be so dangerous. Oh, you can also jump across these little hurdles here. Woo! Oh man, that was one hard stage. I can't believe I was able to get through that. I mean, that was just expert playing right there. So 1-6, and this is our first downhill slope level. It's basically to teach you to control speed. The entirety of World 1 is pretty much a big ol' tutorial, so there's not really much to explain so much per se in terms of the difficulty or gameplay here. It's just control your speed, get the hang of everything, and you should be good to go. Woo! And man, maybe I should do two worlds, at least in this first part, because this is going really, really fast. I mean, I'm only like 5 minutes in this part, and that's way too short for a part. So okay, maybe I'll do two worlds in the first part, and then I'll leave it at that. And I'll improv whenever I need to have more video time per video. So yeah, just some turns, some very easy turns. You've even got a little lip there to bounce off there, if, in case you go a little too fast. Even though that's pretty much impossible. Yeah, because, you know, you have to control yourself to go around the... Well, I guess it's maybe possible. It's impossible for me to, because I've got the hang of the game's controls. This stage might give beginners a bit of trouble. You've got these... See these birds here? They're flapping their wings, and they've got this... See, they're pushing you with their wind, their wing flaps there, and they're going to try and knock you off the edge. Like, here's one without a border, so you just got to push against it as you pass by it. This one is push left, push right, and you're good to go. No problem. Woo! And at the end of every world, there is a boss. Yes, actual bosses and Super Monkey Ball. Can you believe that? Needless to say, its weak spot is its head. This boss... I have a hard time even calling it a boss. It doesn't even try to knock you off the edge. I mean, you got a border all around this entire thing, so I'm just gonna sit here, and it's gonna try and push me off the edge with its wing flaps. I guess it can knock you off the edge like that, but your objective is to hit it on the head, and even if you make mistakes, it's still incredibly hard to fall off the stage. Yeah, he's gonna put his head down in shame because he's such a terrible boss. It warns you that there's a boss approaching, but I guess that warning is like one of those things of it's warning you that this boss is so ridiculously easy that you're going to be bored, so it's like a boring warning of sorts. And don't do that double peck thing again, please. You did it anyway. So you can sometimes hit him when he does it, you know, like if you time it well. And yeah, I guess maybe that's how he's supposed to knock you off, is with his wings like that. But you can tell he's not doing a very good job of it. I would be very surprised if you fell off the stage, even though I'm, like, really messing around here and getting myself bumped around. But you can see why it's so easy to stay on the stage. And our first gold banana is in our possession. Shiny, beautiful banana. Woo! World clear. And let's go to World 2 right away. I guess I can show the credits here, the credits minigame here. You control by moving the Wii remote around. II there acts as your pointer. And the objective is to collect bananas, but don't touch the names there. As you see, they bounce you around. So, I should probably show the credits at least once, and maybe that's what I'll do in this video. Is rather than do two worlds, do the credits, so I won't have to show the credits again. The credits are kind of boring. Just gonna tell you that right now. It's just this minigame, and it's not a very hard minigame. I'm just really messing around here, bouncing around in like a pinball machine of sorts. Not really caring what I collect or whatnot. Since the credits came so early, I might as well do this little disclaimer and say, as usual, that I did not make the game. Sega did. I'm just making the walkthrough on it for entertainment, as well as to help you out. I love making these. It's fun. And carefully get through this gauntlet of bumpers. It wasn't really that hard to do whatsoever. This is what I mean about the credits being pretty boring. You could probably leave this video by now and like not miss anything. So I wouldn't blame you if you did that. I'm getting T-boned. Oh no. There we go. Just get as many bananas as I possibly can, because we know that monkeys love their bananas. And that's why he is working so hard to collect as many bananas as he possibly can. Strangely, not all the words bounce you back. It's just the colored letters, not those white ones there. It kind of doesn't really make much sense in terms of a perspective. You kind of like go behind those ones of the marketing manager or the localization support, but the actual names of the people, nope, those ones are solid, as well as the bumpers, as I said. So I'm very bored, extremely bored right here. I just want to get back to the gameplay. And this music that you're hearing right now, you're gonna see in a much, much, much later world. Well, not see, you're gonna hear it. And ow. I mean, this monkey's just gotta have, like, concussions out the wazoo for getting bumped around so much so far. Although these monkeys do seem very durable, as you've seen in the other Super Monkey Ball games. I mean, they bounce around, get flinged around their balls, and it just seems like nothing happens to them. They are indestructible. Maybe it's because they use the magic words EE poo to protect themselves or something like that. I'm not sure, I'm just trying to rationalize it here. I'm not questioning the game logic, because that could cause the universe to implode and I would not want to have that. So I'm just telling you that right off the bat, just so you don't forget about that. And the credits have to be ending soon, right? Right, please? I beg you to end credits. I mean, I know there's a lot of great people who made this game, and this is a good game. Well, maybe aside from the mini-games, the 50 mini-games in here, it's like 90% of those mini-games are pretty bad. Or at least I think so. Like, they're just boring or plain flat-out broke, and this is the end of the credits! Woo! And that's how I think I'm going to end off this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part. And there's apparently 300 bananas. Oh, I guess I did fairly well. I have no idea what's the best rating, don't ask. And yes, you are rated for your credits, apparently. For your credit collecting. And you put your name by tilting the Wii remote like so. And that's really all that I have to explain here. So, again, hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next parts.